Have you ever wondered what's inside a Catholic church? Well, why don't you join us today and we'll try and explain some things for you.
That's right, Father Charlie. I think every Catholic and even non-Catholics have been inside a church and said, what's that or what's that all about?
You're right. So let's go in and find out.
Sounds good. Welcome. In the last episode, we introduced you to the baptismal font, the paschal candle, and the ambry in what's inside the Catholic Church. Today, we'll explore the altar, the ambo, and the cathedra. Father Charlie, welcome once again.
Thank you, Mark.
Good to have you. Ambo, an interesting word.
Yes, the word is an ancient word. It means step up. And it's from this elevated step that the word of God is proclaimed to the congregants. It's a privileged spot from which the Word of God is proclaimed. It becomes a little altar because God comes to us in His Word. It's a kind of a special presence of God that comes to us in His Word. So we light two candles next to it and proclaim it we're using lectors as well as priests and deacons and bishops. The lectors are commissioned, are trained and commissioned by the church to proclaim the Word of God.
And just like the altar, the ambo always has a reserved, significant spot within the church. We are now at what could be called the apex of the Catholic Church, and that is the altar. And with the crucifix above and nearby cathedra, these are important elements of the liturgy within the Catholic Church. Can you explain the significance of the altar, Father?
Well, it is totally significant. It's the most important element in any Catholic Church. On it is offered the sacrifice of Jesus Christ. Well, I should say the sacrifice of Jesus Christ occurred once and for all. On it, we enter into the sacrifice of Jesus Christ once again. It's both a table of an altar of sacrifice, and it's also a Eucharistic table. It's the banquet table of the Lord, and we receive His precious body and blood from this table, and He nourishes us from it. Underneath is a reliquary of the saints. There's some relics of saints in there to remind us that the early Christians celebrated the Lord's Supper on top of the tombs of the martyrs in Rome, off the Colosseum and in the catacombs. So every Catholic church has in the altar embedded the relics of saints, or in this case, underneath the altar.
And above the altar, here in the Cathedral of St. John, we have a very modernistic approach. The Italian artist designed it to showcase the crucified Christ delivering His spirit over to the Father.
Yes, indeed. And you'll see from the right hand is a representation of a dove. And Jesus, in His dying, hands over the spirit. The spirit that comes to us again in Pentecost when we are empowered by the Holy Spirit. But this particular crucifix has that representation. Every Catholic church will have a major crucifix to remind us that it's the sacrifice of Christ that's taking place here.
Nearby, we have the cathedra, a very large, impressive chair, and that holds a significant place, particularly in a cathedral.
From it, the bishop teaches and guides and nourishes his parish, his diocese. The bishop is one of the successors of the apostles. The bishop is the pastor of his diocese, the teacher of his diocese, the caregiver of his diocese. So that's symbolized from his chair.
And that chair, or cathedra, plays an important role as far as legally giving the archbishop or bishop his entitlement to leadership of a diocese. I know for during the installation services here at the Cathedral of St. John, it wasn't until the archbishop was placed and invited to his cathedra that he took over the reins from his successor.
That's right. He receives the mitre, he receives the shepherd's crook, the crozier, and then he sits on the cathedra.
And takes his role in the new diocese or archdiocese in this case.
He assumes responsibility for the diocese.
In our next episode of What's Inside a Catholic Church, we'll take a look at what, Father Charlie?
First of all, we'll look at the Chapel of Reservation, where the Blessed Sacrament is reserved in a tabernacle. It's a special place for Catholics to spend time with the Lord. Then we'll look at the Reconciliation Chapel, where Catholics confess their sins and receive Christ's loving forgiveness.
So please join us for our next episode of What's Inside a Catholic Church.